Junior. I'm a senator in the Guam Legislature. I'm serving on my fourth term, ending my eighth year. My running mate is not a very popular guy, but I totally like him because he's a teacher. He's a teacher at John F. Kennedy High School. His name is Colonel Dave Cruz. I see some of the Razzi cadets here this morning, and I want to let you know that on the Rodriguez Cruz ticket, our theme is about love. It's about why we're running for Senate, why we're running for governor and lieutenant governor. It's we love you, we love mom. And to show you how much that I love kids in high school today, before I take up my lay, I want to thank you very much for the lay, and I want to show you what I've printed for you.
Thank you, candidates, for your introduction and present here today at our island's first gubernatorial forum this year. We will now proceed into the candidates' question and answer portion. As a reminder to the candidates, each of you will have 1 minute to answer each of the questions.
Which makes you different from the other families and shows us that you will lead our island to the best of your abilities.
The strongest quality that I have to run as governor is, as a mother, very compassionate. Very, very concerned about safety for my children, our children, your children. As a senator, I passed some very landmark legislation, and that one is to prohibit smoking in restaurants, and that has made a difference in our people's lives. As a Bank of Guam president and CEO, I have led our company from a $900 million asset to now a $2 billion company. How cool is that for the people of Guam? As a result, it gave us more opportunities for better lives, better houses, better education. So my skills in compassion, my skill in being focused, my skill in managing people is what will lead this into our future.
I have experience as a lieutenant governor, as a senator, as a police officer, as a father. I've done great things with Governor Eddie Cabo, will continue to do great things. But more than anything else, I know what it is to come from a broken home. I know what it is to struggle every single day. I know what it is for our families and myself to be able to barely make ends meet, going from paycheck to paycheck. I know what it is to struggle and to be able to overcome that struggle. I'm a product of the Guam education system. I graduated from George Washington High School, and I know some of you may have come from there years ago, but ladies and gentlemen, I come with experience, knowledge, and passion. All I have done in my whole life is dedicate myself to the people of Guam in all my professions. I work hard every single day. You will not find a candidate who worked harder for you than Ray Tenorio and Tony Ada. I'm asking for your vote. Please allow us to be your governor and lieutenant governor. Thank you.
I want to say that these are very great leaders. Lieutenant Governor, former Senator Vivian Guerrero. But one of the things is that I'm young, just like you. I'm 40 years old. And so one of the qualities I have is being human, knowing exactly what it is that you feel. Being a father, I have a daughter who is 22 years old. I know what it takes. I know what it is to raise a family, to struggle in life. And that is what it's going to really take this time and this time in our community, in our island. Be able to know how to resolve the solutions we have is when you feel it, is when you go through the challenges, and I've gone through that. And so I'm asking you and your family and your friends to please help me and Colonel Dave Cruz to be your next governor and lieutenant governor of Guam. Thank you.
governor, pick one major issue of our island to kick off your term. What would that issue be and how would you solve it?
Frankly, it's education. Ladies, gentlemen, and students, education is pivotal. Your beauty, your strength, all of the time goes away. This, your mind, makes your future. As I said, I want to give you a free college tuition for every student who's graduated from high school, either Bond Trades Academy, GCC, or UNG. You have to dedicate money for that because by giving you an education, we give you a future. We allow you to be able to achieve your dreams. Building new high schools costs money. Taxpayers, you ladies and gentlemen, you contribute to the community, the community will contribute back to you. If we make you a productive member of the community, so you don't have to go sell drugs, become homeless, or commit crimes to be able to make a living, that is the key to the future. I want to make sure that your education is great, so your dreams can come true. Ladies and gentlemen, Tony and I will make that happen. Give us the opportunity, we'll give the education to give you the life that you want. Thank you very much.
The first major issue that Colonel Dave Cruz and I are going to tackle is healthcare. I'm going to execute the law that I authored that expands health insurance access for all of you. Imagine a day where you and your families can go to a doctor because you have health insurance. You don't have to wait until your sickness, until your flu gets to a worse condition, but you have to end up in the Common Warner Hospital emergency room. Imagine a day when you want to play sports, you tell your parents, I need to get a physical, and you can go to your doctor in any private clinic and say, I want a physical, and your insurance company is going to pay for it. You're not going to have to wait and struggle and think, well, how is my parents going to afford to pay my physical exam to play sports or to do anything in our community? I'm going to make sure that I execute my law that ensures access to health care for all of them, which is awesome.
As a nurse, I would love to give free access to healthcare. As a mother, I would love to give free education to women. But that cannot happen and will never happen until we get our financial house in order. And that's the first thing that I'm going to do as governor. On day one, I will formulate a tax recovery unit and take that unit and make sure we collect $190 million that this administration has not collected over the last 8 years. We didn't really have to raise our taxes. We didn't have to burden our people with increased expenses. What we needed to do is collect the $190 million in taxes that's on the table and being missed by our people of Guam. That's how you get education, healthcare, and safety.
Question number three. As graduating seniors and being 18 years of age, it is our first time having this right to vote. In 1 minute,
pitch
us on why it is important to vote and why
you
should vote for you specifically.
Who's awesome for that question? In 1 minute, it's going to be hard, but I'll tell you. You ever heard them say to you, leaders say to you that you're the leaders of tomorrow, the leaders of the future? I believe that you're the leaders of today. It's what we do today that drives the leaders standing up here today to see how it is we're going to resolve the challenges we have in our community. And so to be able to have a voice in our island, you have to stand up and vote. Register to vote, because if you don't vote, your voices will not be heard. And as I said earlier, I'm young just like you. Exercise your right to vote and make that your quality. Make your beauty your quality. Don't make people tell you that it's not your time. Make it your time, register to vote, because your vote is your voice. Thank you.
Today we are faced with a lot of challenges, and we cannot meet those challenges without you exercising your very sacred civil right as the voter. I urge you to go out there and register to vote so you can influence your destiny in the future. so you can influence education, so you can influence healthcare, so you can make our island safe. Our leadership, the leadership of Josh and Lou Leon-Guerrero, are those leaders that can make that happen. We have experiences in administration, legislation, policy making, administration, finances. We are passionate, we are compassionate, we are good, honest, trustful people. I urge you to vote and vote for Lou and Josh.
When you go to the restaurant, you have a choice between spaghetti, oven pizza, cheeseburger and french fries, or toast. You make the decision. That's your responsibility when you go eat. Don't you make the same decisions when you become part of the community, when you get to be of 18 years of age? You want someone else to choose what you're gonna eat? You decide. You want Luke, Dennis, Frank, Carl, Ray? You decide. This is your power. This is your responsibility. We believe in your abilities. We know what you can do. I know what I can do, and I know what Tony Atta can do. We can make your island greater than it is already. We can make your future even better. Your future is vested in the hands of people who want to make you absolutely amazing. Titans, you already are amazing now. Let's make you better. Jesus Masi, thank you.
What steps would you take as governor to support the buildup of Simon Sanchez High School and to add a football field at Tiyan High School.
We will build your field. Cody, Ada, and I will build your field. We built this gym. We built this school, even in the face of objection. We opened up the JFK, and ladies and gentlemen, we will build Simon Sanchez and GW as well. We need to build and rebuild and renovate all these schools. Almost every major procurement has had these legal issues. There's been a lot of technical things that have been changed by virtue of the policies and the laws. These things affect the procurement. When I first became Lieutenant Governor, we had 5 fire trucks we were supposed to order. It took 2 years of procurement appeals. Then, at the end of it, we could only buy 3. We lost 2 fire engines. This procurement process is a normal, frankly, and it's a problem. We do need to get on top of it. We will build your field. We will finish Simon Sanchez. Thank you.
The first thing I'm going to do as governor is I'm going to ask my lieutenant governor, Colonel Dave, who is a teacher and who was the fiscal property officer of the National Guard, to oversee that Simon Sanchez is built. None of this excuses about it being under protest and procurement. If you do it right, it will be done right. And so we will make sure that the procurement is done right. The lieutenant governor is going to be in charge and on top of every one of our agencies to ensure that when we go out there and put out a procurement request, that it is done right. We're going to build Simon Sanchez under our watch. And as far as your football field, we're going to do it. Either we do it through the DOE system, or we do it through the Barangay Mayor's office. We right now, Senator Joseph Augustine and I have a bill to transfer jurisdiction for about a huge amount of property around the area here to her office so that she can build more sports facilities. We're going to ensure that you are not forgotten and that your needs for a football field and other sports facilities you need are going to be built under our administration. Thank you.
What I would do is go to court and take that procurement process out of court. There is $100 million in monies that is waiting to be spent for Simon Sanchez, for TJ, for renovations in all the different public schools. Why for 4 years have we not taken advantage of that funding and that financing? So I would take it out of court. I will work with your superintendent and give your superintendent the authority and the enforcement to implement the project for Simon Sanchez and your Tiyan Field football field. Josh and I will build your football field. Thank you, Ms. Green.
Question number 6. Recently, Governor Calvo signed off Public Law 34-80 with votes 14-1 by our own legislature. This law adopts the rules and regulations for a program off the ground for a medicinal marijuana laboratory. What are your thoughts on the current legalization of marijuana medicine and recreation here? And how do you feel about the opening of the laboratory?
Thank you very much for the question. Public Law 34-80 is actually my law. It's Bill 210-34. And what this law does is that it sets the motion for our medical marijuana program to move forward. Number one, I don't support recreational marijuana. Number two, for medical purposes, I support it. I want to tell you, in the beginning, I didn't support it either because our doctors, the facts before said that what was being represented wasn't what it is. It's not a cure. Is to help our people that have illnesses, help them go through the pain. However, despite my objections, because this law to allow medical marijuana was the people's vote, the people's mandate. You, your parents said, we want this done, we need to get it done, and that's why I worked very hard to ensure we get it done. And I'm Governor Juan, we're going to make sure we get a lab, either it's a private or public sector that's going to run it, but we're going to make sure that we carry out this law, because this was your law, this was the people's mandate. Thank you very much.
As a nurse, I know the medicinal effects of marijuana. It helps people with cancer. It helps people with diabetes. It helps people with epilepsy. These are the benefits of medical marijuana, and I fully support the legalization of medical marijuana. Laboratory issues, we can get those laboratories outside. There are resources elsewhere that we can bring in. 32 states in the United States have legalized medicinal marijuana. We can tap from them for laboratories. As far as recreational marijuana, I support the decriminalization of marijuana. Everyone, I feel it should be decriminalized, it should be regulated, and should be treated just like legal substances like alcohol beverages. So I do support medicinal and decriminalizing marijuana.
The United States Congress is in session right now. There's bills being considered by both majority and minority parties of the Congress. The national policy will be changed, and I think, very near future. When that happens, we'll get a motion position and make what Lou just talked about possible, so we can do the laboratory work in the other states. Because the cost of the laboratory is one of the single biggest determinants of how we can move forward right now. I know a guy who used to be a police officer, now works in security. He has epileptic seizures for many, many years. And when we left the department, and then he got out and retired, he started using marijuana, and it helped him. He hasn't had an epileptic seizure in years. The difference in his life is night and day. We need to be able to make medicinal marijuana available for individuals who need it, to be able to cure their ailments. Their quality of life, your quality of life, our people's quality of life. Recreational, we need to have a bigger discussion, but I understand where Lou is going. It's a very controversial divisive issue. Thank you.
Question number 7. Since Guam's economy is reliant on tourism, it only makes sense that we should make our island more presentable for newcomers as well as ourselves. Knowing that Guam is currently working to revitalize its appearance, what would you do to either continue or enhance these current efforts?
Our greatest resource in our island is our environment, our land, our waters, our beaches. And we need to keep those resources clean, presentable, and with appearance of pristine. What I would do is work very closely with the village mayors, work very closely with the school leaders, work very closely with the religious leaders, community leaders, nonprofit organizations, to continue what they're doing to keep our island with the appearance of cleanliness, orderliness, so that we can continue attracting our tourists here, as tourism is our greatest economy for people of Guam. Josh and I will make sure that happens. Please vote for us. Thank you.
We have painted and renovated over 700 bus stops. We've adopted and launched the roadway adoption program. We've adopted beaches and we've done all kinds of cleanup. We've cleaned up so much stuff, but there's always stuff coming back. I want to say that Guam's greatest resources are guys like Wayne Santos and people like you, every one of you. I know you have a school teacher here that takes you out and does cleanups all the time. Those are great things. When you clean up a community, you make a difference, become vested. We've made so many businesses. Have you seen down in the south where we clean up the tanga and the sakati at the side of the road and we cut it down and you see those beautiful vistas? That's the stuff we need to continue to do. Toniata, as a lieutenant governor, will assume the role that I have now in charge of beautification. I think our island's beautiful because of its people and its land and its seas. Thank you very much.
For starters, I'm going to ensure that the people support and expand Mr. Norman Aguilar's GCC's Lodging and Management Program Academy. I want to thank Tiyan High for doing your first forum last year on tourism. That's what it's going to take. It's going to take every one of us to understand that tourism works for Guam. And so we welcome our visitors enthusiastically, welcome them with a holiday spirit. They're going to remember us for that. Number two, we're going to ensure that our site, our historic site. I have a legislative initiative right now that is ongoing to revitalize Inarahan. Inarahan is one of those registered sites in the National Registrar. We're going to ensure that we revitalize Inarahan. We look at other sites of Guam that we can revitalize so our visitors can come back and not just enjoy our beaches, our weather, our sand, and our people, but to also know our culture and our identity as the people of Guam, which is awesome.
This is not my role to ad lib, this is your role to ad lib. This will be your governor's office. This will be your government. Our strategy is simple. We want to make the island great. I want to return everything that this island has made me. I grew up here. I came from a foster family. I came from a broken home. I came from a family that didn't have much money. I understand the pains that many people are suffering. I want to make the island great because you deserve greatness. I want to make you smart because you deserve it. I want to give you the education because that helps you accomplish your dreams. My road to Adloop is your road to Adloop. So get your phone out. My number is 482-1432, 482-1432. You can call me, text me, email me, whatever. WhatsApp, I'm all over the place. But ladies and gentlemen, you can get involved because this is your island. You are Guam, we are Guam, and you're going to win. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for that final question. The approach that we're taking is that we're being accessible, we're being open and transparent to the people of Guam, to you. And so how we're doing that is we're going to you, we're going to your parents, we're going to your house, knocking door to door, to ask you to look at our vision, understand our vision, and consider voting for us to be your next governor and lieutenant governor of Guam. Just like Lieutenant Governor Ray Tenorio, since I became elected, since I was a senator, I've given out my personal cell phone number, and that is 687-1573. Please call me, text me, I'm always open to listen to you. That's the approach that we're going to take, is to be open and transparent with you. And how we're going to ask you to get involved is to listen to us so that we can listen to you and understand what it is that we want to do for you and the people of Guam. Follow us on Facebook, Rodriguez Cruz 2018. Follow us on Twitter. Go to our website at welovegua.com to understand and know who Rodriguez Cruz is about. Thank you very much.
Josh and I, over the last year, have been going out to the communities, going out to the villages, going out to people's homes. Why? Because we want to hear from you. During our visiting tours, we talk about ourselves. And we talk about what we want to do. But more importantly, we get questions from the audience. What are their concerns? How do you think we can resolve their concerns? That's one of the most basic methods of campaigning that we have done. We are in social media, we are in Instagram, we are on Facebook, we are on Twitter. We use what the millennials use in terms of getting our message. Most importantly, we have a headquarters, and our headquarters number is 922-2018. Model personal cell number is 727-8122. My phone number is 646-8122. Thank you, and this is really awesome.
Each of the candidates will now make their closing remarks. As a reminder, each candidate will have 30 seconds to close.
Again, thank you so much for having the opportunity to meet you and to give you what some of my thoughts are, what some of my strategies are, what some of my skills are. And it's all really, really, really for change. Are you ready with change? Because I'll be there with you. I want to again thank you, and please vote for Lou and Josh, and vote this August. your voice is very strong. Thank you, Institute Mark.
DLT asked me if you can go last, so I said, okay, you can go last. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you very much for the opportunity to be here today. I want to thank you for the opportunity the teachers and the administration has given us to be with you. The permanent leaders and I are running for governor, lieutenant governor, because we love you, we love Guam. We want to ask you to give us that chance, give us that opportunity, because we're just like you. We're going to fight to ensure that the government is fair and it's level playing field for everyone. Fair for you, like fair for your families. And your families, thank you very much. Please go on and do this. Viva Titans, viva Visa House.
I want to ask you to vote for the Royal Island. This is why. TK Borja, Miss Team Guam, got crowned last night. She is the number one Titan right now. She's like all of you. She can achieve anything. You put yourself to it. You put your mind to it. You work hard. You get your family involved. You listen to people. And finally, at the end of it, you're crowned. We want to give you everything the Titans deserve, and we will. Vote for Tony Ada and Ray Tenorio. Your future is amazing. Thank you.
Now students here at Tiyan High School giving the certificates of appreciation to those candidates that were able to show up here at Tiyan High School for their gubernatorial forum. We did have the candidates, the gubernatorial hopeful, Senator Dennis Rodriguez Jr., the Lieutenant Governor, Ray Tenorio, as well as Lulian Guerrero, some of the Lieutenant Governor candidates here with them. Of course, we heard that Senator Frank Hogan Jr. could not make today a vote, did show up initially. Cannot make it to be a part of the forum because he attended to session the discussion for his bill for Simon Sanchez High School there. And also he just got on the phone prior to the forum with former Governor Carl Gutierrez, who confirmed that he won't be attending. We're going to hope to speak with him after to find out more about his reason behind that. But of course the candidates did hear several questions, at least 8 questions from the students here today, talking about several issues, including what they felt is the strongest quality for them to lead this island, other issues like what they plan to do, the first issue they plan to kick off when their term, whenever, whoever takes the helm over at Attleboo. as well as why they feel it's important for the students, for those here that are going to be eligible this year to vote, why it's important for them to vote. The most important issue, a couple of the most important topics included whether they should arm teachers. One of them, Lilian Guerrero, saying that she does not support arming teachers in the classroom. She said that we should leave that up to the safety officers and to the policemen, and they are, she said, that more than in the field. For Ray Tenorio, he said that there's a need to talk about arming more school resource officers, of course, and there should be a possibility of having lock boxes as well as a safety measure. Finally, Senator Dennis Rodriguez Jr. saying that not necessarily about arming teachers, but that he supports arming school resource officers, and so that was one major issue. Another major topic that was discussed, that before we bring it to the back and show you what else is going on as students are being heading back to the classroom, was medicinal marijuana and recreational marijuana. We did hear from Tenorio, who said that, of course, the feds have ongoing discussions about that, and that Senator Dennis Rodriguez Jr., although doesn't support recreational marijuana, did say that he does have measures in place to move the medicinal marijuana measures forward and get the laboratories open. As for Lilian Guerrero, she said as a nurse, she knows the benefits for medicinal marijuana, supports that, but that she also supports recreational marijuana decriminalization and regulating of the drug. And so that's some of the responses that we heard here today at the TZN Tutorial Forum. We'll have a full wrap up of what happened here tonight on KUA News, as well as on KUA.com. Getting to the back here for those that are eligible to vote. Hello. Of course, they are excited for the first time voters. They have a registration area here set up in the back for those students. We'll see you tonight on Primetime.